What are the best natural ways to lower cholesterol? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Hi.
Thank you so much. I want to thank you for all the COVID information that has been so incredibly useful. I have two questions. So I'm an active 68-year-old woman who I eat right, I do everything right, and for 30 years I've been avoiding a statin because my LDLs are just, and they just keep going up. And I just recently went on a statin because I have family history of stroke, and I'm starting to get to that age where I'm like, no way am I having a stroke. And so do you have any recommendations for, I've tried pantothenic acid, I've done niacin, I've done everything. If there's anything that you can recommend, that would be helpful.
Okay. I guess the top things that I would think of to lower cholesterol levels are, number one, I'd get thyroid status thoroughly checked out. Sometimes that's an issue. Number two, I would consider experimenting with a diet low in saturated fat or a diet low in cholesterol to see how responsive your levels are to those things. Probably a 75% drop from what you're currently eating would be a good test to see if there's an effect. Number three, I would experiment with some fiber supplements. Psyllium husk is a good one to try. Number four, I don't think this is relevant for you, but for people who are overweight, then normalizing body composition is an issue. Number five, I wouldn't use pantothenic acid. I would try pantethine, and then I would look at the dose. Pantethine. And what dose were you using?
I think it was 900 milligrams.
Yeah. Okay. If that didn't work, then it's not going to work. And so if you try pantothenic, you've tried niacin, then I think there's a couple other things that could be relevant. Sometimes copper deficiency can raise cholesterol levels. Sometimes magnesium deficiency is involved, but those are the big levers. And if you've pulled them all and you haven't gotten results, then I think you're unlikely to get results without taking a statin. If you do choose to take a statin, then I would be careful to take coenzyme Q10 and the MK4 form of vitamin K2 to make sure that you are vitamin K2 has a form called MK4. Statins inhibit the synthesis of MK4. And MK4 is the form of vitamin K2 that plays some essential roles that, that are so essential that we will convert other forms of vitamin K to it, but statins interfere with that process. And so, and so I would be careful to supplement with that as well.
This episode was part of a Q&A from members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount.
From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book.
In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.